आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव।
आजादी का सफर विद एआईआर न्यूज। India's glorious fight for freedom is one of the greatest struggles the modern world has ever witnessed. AIR News brings you a glimpse of the valiant struggle every day. Annie Besant, a great social reformer and one of the most iconic exponents of the Indian freedom movement, was born on the 1st of October 1847 in London. She was involved in the free thought and radical movements led by Charles Bradlaugh, MP.
She advocated ideas which were ahead of the time, such as trade unions, national education, right for women to vote, and birth control. In 1889, Annie Besant joined the Theosophical Society, a religious movement based on Hindu ideas of karma and reincarnation. In 1893, she represented the Theosophical Society at the World Parliament of Religions in Chicago.
Nama nama Vasant Devi Jagat Vandite Prajvalite Jnana Jyoti Sakal Janahite.
She came to India in 1893 and fell in love with the land. She was associated with various causes including the emancipation of women, education, and most notably took part in the Indian freedom struggle. Once Mahatma Gandhi said about her that she awakened Indian people from their deep slumber.
Along with Lokmanya Tilak, she co-founded the Home Rule League in 1916, which aimed to campaign for democracy in India and dominion status within the empire.
In June 1917, when she was arrested by the British Empire, it was vehemently opposed by both Congress and the Muslim League. When Besant was freed in September 1917, she was welcomed by the crowds from all over India. Later, she was elected as the first woman president of the Indian National Congress in December 1917.
She established Banaras Hindu University in 1916 with the assistance of Maharaja of Darbhanga Rameshwar Singh, Maharaja of Banaras Prabhu Narayan Singh, Madan Mohan Malviya, and Sundarlal.
In 1898, later, she also helped in establishing the Hyderabad Sindh National Collegiate Board, Mumbai, India, in 1922.
Raghupathi Venkataratnam Naidu was born on 1st of October 1862 in Machilipatnam in Andhra Pradesh. As his father, Raghupathi Appaya Naidu worked as subedar in the army. He lived in Chandrapur. This helped him gained knowledge of Hindi, Urdu, and Persian languages.
He graduated from Madras Christian College. He continued further education to complete MA and LT from the University of Madras. He founded the Social Purity Association in 1891 to train people as honest citizens.
He worked for the eradication of untouchability and uplift of scheduled castes, and founded an orphanage and a hostel for them. He strived for the abolition of the Devadasi system in Andhra and succeeded to a considerable extent. He promoted widow remarriages and encouraged women's education.
He promoted Brahmo Samaj movement in Andhra. All the above social reforms have led to him being described as the second great social reformer of Andhra after Veera Salingam Panthulu. He breathed his last on the 26th of May, 1939.
On this day, Hridya Nath Kunzru was born in the year 1887. He was an Indian freedom fighter and public figure. He was also a seasoned parliamentarian, serving in various legislative bodies at the provincial and central level for nearly four decades.
He was a member of the Constituent Assembly of India from 1946 to 1950 that drew up the Constitution of India. He was also keenly interested in the international affairs and co-founded the Indian Council of World Affairs and the Indian School of International Studies. He breathed his last on the 3rd of April, 1978.
That brings us to the end of this episode of Azadi Ka Safar, AIR News Ke Sang. See you in the next episode tomorrow.